Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit.
Hey creators, it's Crispy here. Have you ever wondered what it would look like if we were to make an audio reactive, generative music video out of Drake's Toosie slide? Probably not. But I did. And I love working with 3D pixels because it looks so cool. So if I don't sneak that in there, I'm probably just gonna kill myself.
Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody got a piece in it. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street shit.
First, I wanna load the movie. Second, I'm gonna wanna break down the pixels into colors, color by color. Third, I'm going to want to create a new variable to store the original color from the image. Fourth, I'm going to want to figure out if we want to redraw this out of rectangles, circles, or points. And finally, we want to control the size of every pixel and the space in between. Alright, I'm getting excited here. I don't know about you. Alright, I'm going to do what we always do, and I'm going to load setup and draw. If you don't know what we're doing right now, don't worry, I'm gonna have a whole tutorial series on the basics of processing. Okay, so now we're gonna wanna use the My Movie function to load the movie. Oh shoot, I said processing.sound, my bad. Processing.video. All right, now I'm gonna load the processing file. That's gonna be linked to a source on your computer. Let's see if this video is gonna play. Come on.
Nothing seems to be happening.
This is supposed to be the easy part. This is gonna be a link to wherever you have your video file. So we're gonna want to make sure that we can access this file to load into processing. So we go to sketch, show sketch folder, and make sure that there is a data folder. Paste the exact name. We want to actually read the movie and break down the pixels. And so we can see it, add m.play.
And we're getting a bug.
What the hell? I almost forgot to make sure that my data folder was named properly as data. It has to be lowercase data, otherwise processing is going to give you this error and you're going to hate your life.
We needed to add the movie as an image and mymovie.loop. Let's hope this works.
Yeah, we got a movie. All right, now that the easy part's done, let's move on to the next. I'm gonna wanna break this movie down pixel by pixel. And really what that means, we're gonna load 60 frames per second and analyze every single row and every single column. That's a lot of computer processing power. So we're gonna wanna use a nested for loop in order to break this thing down.
So for now, we're just gonna write a normal for loop structure. Copy the for loop and put it in draw. And they need to be identical because they're gonna be working with one another.
We're gonna wanna actually figure out how to redraw these pixel by pixel in our draw function. Hey, I know this is not the easiest thing in the world. So if you're already confused, don't worry. This is just to show you what's possible. I'm gonna do a breakdown about for loops in another video. Next, we're gonna wanna use an array. So what is an array? It's a list to be able to store data, all right? So I'm gonna wanna store color data in this list and then call upon it later. Or we could just load random colors instead.
Okay, we need to make an integer for block size and it's gonna be one. This is gonna be a color array. First in setup, we're gonna wanna call upon this new My Movie colors.
So I want to make sure that I'm grabbing every single color from Drake's Toosie slide original video. Keep in mind that we're going to end up redrawing thousands and thousands of pixels 60 times per second. How many pixels is that exactly? It's going to be this much if you want to calculate how many pixels this is per minute. Whew, I can barely say that number without getting tired. Now I need a way to find the X and the Y position relative to the width. And how do we do that? Math. Yay! Everybody loves math, right? I actually hate math.
Then above that, we're gonna wanna put what numpixels means. The formula for numpixels is gonna be the width divided by block size. Remember, block size is just one. So that's just width divided by one so that we can control the block size later on.
Luckily, we have a simple little algorithm, X plus Y times width, so that we can know where every pixel actually is in its location. So we're gonna create a new variable and call that location. or LOC for short.
Now we're gonna wanna actually use those news variables inside of the for loop. So we first just created our movie color array, and then we've added the algorithm.
Use the algorithm, they said. Bullshit.
This beautiful algorithm right here is gonna help us to be able to use our X plus Y times the width, because numpixels, remember, it's just our width divided by the block size, which is only one.
Thank you, gods of programming, who have come before me.
Hey, Stevie.
Dan Schiffman.
Pen Fry.
This is always the hardest part. But hey, if you want to learn more about any of the functions I'm using, I'm going to put a link below so you guys can go ahead and research this to your heart's desire. I'll probably just make a video about it too. Now that we have the algorithm, next we're going to do getPixel. So in human language, this would literally be saying, find the pixel in this location and extract the color and then save that color so we can use it later. So remember, a pixel array is a list of color pixels, right? So now we're gonna wanna connect the function of getting a color with a list so that can be stored.
Next, we're gonna create that variable for location, because now you can see how we're connecting the get pixel, and then we're going to use that get pixel information so that we can redraw the color based off the original move.
Let's just make a quick test to see if get pixel is running. Let's see what happens.
Finally, it works.
Awesome. Looks like it's working, but it doesn't look that pretty and it's really slow.
Why am I having so many problems?
Well, I guess we found out we're not going to be using ellipses because it takes too much processing power and gets way too slow.
It's actually really hard to put together all of these different functions at first, so don't worry. Finally, we're going to want to draw new shapes and then use the pixel location for every single shape. Then we're going to add new colors to those shapes. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and just use points. Why? If we're gonna re-render this many pixels per second, points are gonna be a lot more manageable versus a circle, which requires 4 points per circle. Whereas if I do point, it's only gonna have 1 point per pixel. This is gonna be a lot easier to render, as well as I'm really curious to see what it looks like with just points. If we didn't do this, we're gonna get into latency issues, and then you're gonna hate your life. Yeah, I know.
Okay, now that we need our point, we just need to make sure it's inside of our second for loop in draw. So let's see what happens. And,
aw, oh, man. It didn't work because we only have black points. We haven't added fill to add any colors from the original movie.
What's the difference between loading a movie and this? If we just loaded the movie with the regular movie function, we wouldn't be able to break it down pixel by pixel. By doing it this longer way, we're gonna be able to control every single red, every single blue, every single green, alpha, everything. All under our artistic freedom to be able to do whatever the hell we want. I know, I promised you guys 3D pixels. So now we're gonna throw that in there.
And I'm really excited.
But not yet. First, let's just add some color. I love B3D. There's gonna be some crazy abstract, like highly saturated colors in the movie. I can even add RG and B channels and separate to control each color.
So now we're gonna be able to add our stroke using those colors. Awesome, now we have our RG and our B used for the stroke to be filling the colors on our point. Okay, next I just need to add a stroke weight, and then let's go ahead and press play and see what happens.
What the heck, all that work?
Okay, so what went wrong? We're gonna wanna make sure we have our black background.
All right, I feel like we're at a pretty good place to test this thing now, I hope. Yes, it worked. All right, let's make one of these boring 2D pixels into 3D pixels. Yes. I'm gonna make all of these pixels into 3D by adding P3D, and then we're gonna go down and we're gonna add a Z property to all of our positions.
If you notice, we have P3D inside of our setup for full screen. That makes our processing display 3D instead of 2D. So we're gonna have our Z based off of brightness.
Z creates that extra 3D space, you know, we've got our X, we've got our Y, and we have our Z, which goes forwards and backwards, right? So just keep that in mind. We could just load random numbers, but while we do that, instead, we're gonna use this trick where we use the brightness as the Z space. This way, for whatever color is gonna be black, it's gonna be in the background, and then whatever is going to be the brightest pixel on the image is gonna be as the foreground. So the black is gonna be the furthest away from the perspective, and the white is gonna be the closest. If that didn't make any sense, don't worry, it's going to. Next, we're gonna wanna load an MP3 file. So just like the video, we wanna make sure that file is actually located inside of our data folder.
Okay, we need to add our sound library. Okay, now we're gonna have file equals new sound file to load our MP3. Now we have file.play to play the file. And we need to make sure we add a name for file at the top.
So now we're gonna wanna use amp equals new amplitude. This allows us to really just break down the sound amplitude band into numbers and then use those numbers as anything we really want.
Next, we're gonna add our amplitude. Need to make sure amplitude is at the top as well. This is going to allow the processing sound library to analyze the song based off of its amplitude and give us a sound wave band to use. Now we can just use V in place of amp.analyze inside of our for loops below.
Okay, now we're gonna add our volume in addition to our Z. So I did BR plus V. This 1.2 is just the intensity of the brightness. I know that's kind of confusing because we already used brightness, right? From black to white, as far as what's furthest to closest. But now think of it like furthest to closest plus audio. So there's gonna be a default Z depth with the addition to every single time the sound changes. That Z is gonna get closer and further, closer and further, closer and further.
Now let's go ahead and press play and see how this thing looks.
If you notice, the waveforms are now changing based off the music.
Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody got a piece in it. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street shit.
Yes, finally. Now you see what I was telling you about, right? So we're pretty much done. But the inner artist inside of me would hate it if I were to stop right here. So we're gonna just polish some things up, experiment a little bit. This is really where you get into the creative process. Once the code is already there, you can choose the colors, the size, and make any dimensional changes on the brightness, tweaking little values till it's just right.
Okay, I'm gonna add the host effects library to add some GLSL polishing effects.
Now we have our experimental 3D audio reactive abstract music video with our good old friend Drake. Take it away, Drake.
Black leather glove, no sequins. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite shit. Nike crossbody got a piece in it. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street shit. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Toosie slide, then I hit it double time. Then I hit a spin, cause we spun that block a couple times. If it's not the right time, it'll always be another time. I'm not even tripping, we'll just see him in the summertime. Whoa, yeah. Can't describe the pressure I be putting on myself, yeah. Really, I just can't afford to lose nobody else, yeah. If they moving shaky, we'll just do the shit ourselves, well. If I'm moving shaky, Chels will do the shit himself, yeah. Solo niggas on a YOLO for real. Heard a lot about you, but we don't know for real. Next time, guarantee the truth will get revealed. Black leather glove, no seat.
Like that video, you're gonna love the next one.
If you want first access to the code from this video and all my other videos, come to artnowcoding.com.
And remember, if that was too confusing, I'm gonna have videos that break down everything coming up next.